This is the Autel MaxiCharger AC Wallbox Home 40A, and in my honest opinion, I think it's one of the best EV home chargers on the market today, with some really unique features at a really amazing price point. But first, let's break down that crazy name. Autel is a manufacturer known for automotive diagnostic and testing equipment, and as of June 2022, it's getting into the EV charging game here in the US. The MaxiCharger AC name designates this as a high-powered level 2 240-volt AC EVSE, which stands for Electric Vehicle Supply Equipment, or commonly referred to as an EV charger. This 40A version of this charger can provide up to 40 amps of current, or 9.6 kilowatts of power to your car. And depending on the efficiency of your vehicle, this will provide somewhere between 19 and 38 miles of range per hour. The 40A is plugged into either a NEMA 650 or 1450 outlet, and Autel also sells a 50 amp hardwire version, which can provide up to 50 amps of current or 12 kilowatts of power, but that unit is hardwired. The Wallbox portion of the name refers to the installed location of the charger on the wall, or more generally across the industry, Wallbox refers to non-portable EVSEs, which deliver more power than some portable chargers, especially if you compare this against a level 1 120 volt charger, like those that come with your car. Finally, home refers to where this charger is designed to live. It's a high-powered Wallbox EVSE for your home, which puts it into the same class as similar products by Tesla, Grizzly E, Juicebox, ChargePoint, Wallbox, Emporia, Flow, Clipper Creek, and many others. Now, in full disclosure, I was provided this review unit by Autel, but I've done as best I can to maintain as neutral a stance as possible. Honestly, that wasn't very hard, as I really do like this thing. Well, the MaxiCharger arrived in this nice box. It obviously included the charger body, the cord, and the plug as a single unit. And then there's this mounting bracket, or the dock, as Autel calls it. There's the hardware needed to mount the charger to the wall, as well as two Torx keys. And then finally, this second box contains a separate holster cable hook and its mounting dock and hardware. When it comes to installation, the 1450 or plugged-in version of the MaxiCharger is very easy to install. Autel says it will take you about 8 minutes, but that's going to vary depending on your particular situation. In my case, it was a little quicker than this, but I was just installing it here on my test stand. First, you install the mounting dock, approximately 14 inches above your NEMA 1450 or 650 outlet. Likely, the outlet is mounted to a stud, so you can screw the dock into that same vertical stud. If not, the MaxiCharger does come with drywall anchors. With the dock mounted, the charger slips into the slots at the top of the dock and is secured with a single T25 security Torx screw at the bottom. If you've mounted everything correctly, the charger should easily plug into your NEMA outlet. And obviously, if you have the hardwired version, this is just going to be a lot more work to get the charger connected to your power supply. For this remote holster version of the MaxiCharger, the holster is mounted in almost the exact same way. The plate or dock is mounted first, and then the holster slipped onto it from the top and secured by a T25 screw. And interestingly, the cable can be coiled around the charger body or the holster hook. And this is because Autel also sells a version of the MaxiCharger AC Wallbox Home with an integrated holster where the cord wraps around the charger body. And since both units have the same housing, the cord can be coiled around the charger, even for the remote holster version. You probably want this remote holster version if you want to store the plug end of the cord in a location that's closer to your vehicle's charge port. For instance, if your NEMA outlet's not directly next to your charge point, you could have your charger at the outlet and have the plug near the charge port. Once we get the charger installed, it's time to set up all of the connectivity features of the MaxiCharger. When you open the Autel Charge app, you must first create an account. And this was the only part of the setup that I really struggled with, as I had to jump back and forth between the email and the app to retrieve verification codes. And these codes would expire very quickly before I had my password all set up and put in. And after about 4 or 5 attempts, I finally got my copy and pasting game refined to the point where I was able to complete the setup. But once that was in, connecting to the charger was much easier. I simply scanned the QR code on the Quick Start Guide and linked to the charger. the charger connected to my phone via Bluetooth, and then I configured the Wi-Fi connection by connecting it to my Wi-Fi network. Before you finish setup, you have the option to set the maximum charge current. My 1450 outlet is on a 40 amp circuit, and so I set the max charge current to 32 amps or 80% of the circuit's rated load. And this is because an EVSE should never be configured to draw more than 80% of the circuit breaker value for the circuit that it's installed on. Say for a 40 amp breaker, this would be 32 amps, which is 80% of 40. To take advantage of the full 40 amp output capacity of this particular charger, it would need to be installed onto a 50 amp circuit. The maximum current can also be adjusted manually by opening up the inside cover of the charger and rotating this little switch. Jumping back to the setup menu, you can configure the MaxiCharger to start charging whenever a vehicle is plugged in. And I'll talk more about this in a little bit as to why this is even an option. You also have the option of providing an electricity price, which allows the app to report the cost of the electricity used to charge your car. And finally, you can name your MaxiCharger. At this point, you're all set up and you're ready to charge. After plugging my Chevy Bolt in, you can see that the app reports that the vehicle is charging, and we can see energy and duration details for this particular session. We also have the option to stop the charge session from the app if we want to. The app has the typical smart charger features like historic charge session information, scheduling, integration with Autel's public charging network, although you're not going to find many of those out there in the wild today. The MaxiCharger can also update its firmware automatically, or you can download the latest update from Autel and install it as needed. But the standard smart app features don't really tell the whole story of this charger, as Autel has built more connectivity into the MaxiCharger than just about any other home EVSE on the market. It has Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, which are pretty normal, and it will be able to distribute the load between multiple chargers on the same circuit. And it's also claimed that it will be able to talk to other energy monitoring systems and respond to changes in household demand. But it also has Ethernet and RFID capabilities, and these are not typical in home chargers. I find the RFID functionality really interesting, especially in situations where your MaxiCharger could be placed in a public or semi-public setting. Let's say in a parking garage of an apartment building. And if your charger's tied into your electric supply or metered separately by the landlord, it'd be nice if you could prevent your neighbors from mooching off your electricity supply. Enter the Autel charge card. One or more of these RFID-enabled charge cards can be linked to the MaxiCharger home. And if you disable the auto start feature, the charger cannot be activated unless the linked charge card is placed over the RFID indicator. If you do happen to have the card though, you simply plug in, tap the charge card, and begin charging, and another simple tap will stop the session. I've never seen this feature on EVSE marketed for home use, and I think it adds considerable value, as commercial public units cost a lot more than residential units. I could also see this being used in public settings or semi-public settings, such as at a hotel, where guests could be given the card to activate their session, but others outside the hotel could not use the charger. In my opinion, the MaxiCharger AC Wallbox Home is a beautiful, well-designed charger. I personally like the angular, simple design. And then there's this large glass screen that's non-functional on the Wallbox Home with only these indicator lights along the bottom edge. But on Autel's commercial version of this charger, this space is a functional touchscreen, and I think that's neat that they've incorporated the same design elements, keeping it consistent while making it attractive across all of their products. The leftmost indicator is the power indicator that indicates when power is supplied to the unit. Next is the Wi-Fi connection indicator, the charging connection indicator to indicate when you're charging, the Bluetooth connector indicator, and finally the RFID connection point. Size-wise, the charger battery is comparable to other wall-mounted EVSEs. It's not particularly big, not particularly small. It's 7.7 inches wide, 13.2 inches high, and 3.4 inches deep. The plug holster is really nice. It has this nice swiveling action to allow the holster to pivot when the plug is put into it. And then also, the hole is a little bit larger, so it's really easy to slam the plug into the holster and not have to worry about alignment. And that just makes it a lot easier to use on a day-to-day basis. All maxi chargers come with 25-foot cables, which is pretty much industry standard length at this point. And I measured the cord diameter at 18.1 millimeter, which is a hair thick for a charger supplying this level of power. But my guess is that Autel is using the same cable across this and their higher 50 amp units, which means that the size is a little bit bigger to handle that extra current. Still, the cable appears to be quite nice and flexible. It's a rubberized material, and it's easy to manipulate and coil at the hot summertime temperatures in my garage. But I'll leave it to Tom Malagni to freeze this thing before we declare it great in cold weather. The J1772 connectors, a nice rubberized connector, very similar to other EVSEs at this price point. Since I was curious, I did open up the unit to check out the internals. Presumably, I voided the warranty in the process. I think that the main circuit board on this thing is one of the best designed I've ever seen in an EVSE. The way everything is laid out in neat rows and separated into distinct sections speaks to the care that was taken by whoever designed this unit. Also, the circuit board is covered by a conformal coating, and this should help protect against any moisture that would make its way past the extensive sealing on this unit. But most amazingly were some of the thermal management considerations that have been taken. The circuit board is directly mounted to a large aluminum heatsink that protrudes through the backside of the unit, and this should provide superior internal cooling relative to most EVSEs out there. Autel claims the working temperature at full load is about 18 degrees Fahrenheit or 10 degrees Celsius cooler than a typical Wallbox style unit, and this should help them achieve their 10-year target lifespan. I always say that for an EV charger, safety is close to the top of things you should be concerned about. And the reason for this is obvious. When you're considering that this thing is pumping out 40 amps of current to your car all night long. This is similar to the power required by an electric oven or stove, but it differs in that it will be pulling current continuously for say up to 8 hours or so. A continuous load like this will tend to place extraordinary demands on the electronic components inside, and for this reason, I only recommend buying units that have been certified by a well-established testing laboratory. Here in the US, we have UL Underwriters Laboratory, or ETL, the Intertech Testing Laboratory. In Canada, there is the CSA Group, which tests products to North American standards, beyond the US a little bit. There are also testing laboratories in Europe and throughout the rest of the world. And this maxi charger is CSA certified, which means it passes certifications to North American standards. Like pretty much all EVSEs, this charger has built-in GFCI protection, or ground fault circuit interrupter protection. And GFCI protection protects against system failures that would lead to dangerous electrical shocks. It's similar to what's going on inside those rectangular electrical outlets in your bathroom or kitchen, and that's the one with those test and reset buttons. The system continuously monitors for current leakages and will trip the primary relay the instant it detects a leakage. So this little tester can simulate a charge, and it also has the ability to trip the ground fault on the charger. So we'll plug it in, and then we will signal it to charge. It's charging. And then we simply trip the ground fault, and you'll see that the charger goes into error mode like it should. So works perfectly well. Reset it by pulling it out, and it's good to go again. Most EVSEs have a good degree of environmental sealing, which allows them to be used in outdoor environments. Most drivers will charge in their garage, but some people will want to mount it on the side of a building or even out on a post in the open. And the MaxiCharger is NEMA 4 rated, which allows you to do that because it's dust and watertight and should be able to handle directed jets of water sprayed onto it. And there you can see it is charging, so it passes the weather sealing test, no problem at all. So what does this thing cost? Because that can really be a deal breaker for these fully functioned smart EV chargers. As of July 2022, the MaxiCharger AC Wallbox Home 40A retails for $559, with the hardwired 50 amp version coming in at $599. And for a charger with this level of features, smart features, and the build quality, I think this is perhaps one of the best values out there today. For instance, comparable chargers start at around $600 and they run to over $1,000, and some do not offer some of the unique features that this does, such as the RFID control and Ethernet connection support. So if you are in the market for a smart home charger, I would highly recommend you give the Autel MaxiCharger a look. And I won't ding it for the name. If you're interested in purchasing the MaxiCharger Home AC Wallbox 40A, did I get it right? You can find a link in the description, or over there now. And if you have any other questions that I haven't answered in this video, drop a comment down below. It's still down there. And I'll do my best to answer that. And finally, if you're interested in more EV charging related content and reviews, I do have a few more chargers I'll be running through my review process in the near future. So stay tuned for that. And I will see you in the next one.